there you are. So have you already caught enough? Or do you want to keep looking some more?
I think that's about all I could find. I hope that's enough.
Yeah, that's awesome. Thank you so much. I could never have found that many without you. I am sure that was fun. Wasn't it?
No, it wasn't. Just tell me what your last wish is and let's be through with this.
I'm sorry. I really thought you would like that. Just give me some time to take the jars back home, okay? Then I'll tell you what my last wish is.
Ah, there you are. It was really nice of you to help Reneas find those butterflies. He's been trying to catch them for months now, but he's just not fast enough. You know, whenever I see the two of you, I can't help but see you as siblings. You should really think about settling down here. I'm sure the village could use someone with your abilities. Oh my, I'm rambling, aren't I? I think Reneas has prepared something for you. He's waiting near the back door.
Walk blessed.
Hey, good to see you. Are you ready for my last wish? I think you will like it.
I think I am. What is it?
I'll tell you in a moment. Let's go to the old ruin near the waterfall. I've prepared a little surprise for you there. Come, lead the way.
Walk blessed.
Here. It's awesome in here, isn't it? Take a look around if you want. Ta-da! That's the surprise I promised you. Do you see it? That's us, on the beach here in Silvergrove, right where we tested the sphere. Do you like it? It's really nice, isn't it?
Who painted this? You?
Why? Of course me. Who else? It turned out really well, didn't it?
This is ridiculous. I don't have time for this.
What? But I thought it would make you happy. But it was a stupid idea. I see that now. I will paint another one, and this time it will be better. I swear. Can I tell you my last wish now? After that, I will give you the stone. Just like we agreed. I promise.
Go ahead. What is your last wish?
I want you to stay here.
What?
I want you to stay and be part of the family. I'm sure Daddy would let you move in if I ask him. Then we could play together every day. And every night, we'd have supper with Daddy like we were siblings. It would be so great, wouldn't it?
Have you lost your mind? I'm not going to stay here.
But why not? Why? I just don't understand. It's so much better here in Silvergrove than anywhere else. No one is ever hungry or sick, and there are never any clouds or rain. What is there in that stupid city that you need to get back to? The world out there, it's so cruel. So cold.
Ryan News, I.
Or is it me? It's me, isn't it? I've been a bad little brother to you, and all my games were stupid and boring. But I will change all that, I promise. I just don't want you to leave. Without you, I'll be alone again. And I don't want to be alone anymore.
Alone? What are you talking about? You won't be alone here, even when I leave.
Yes, I will be. There's something I need to tell you, but I'm afraid that you will hate me when I do. Just like all the others.
I will not hate you, Ryan News. What is it that you need to explain to me?
It's just, I don't know where to start. I never wanted them to be trapped here. You have to believe me, but it was the only way to make them love me. Back then, they were always mean to me, even though I never did anything wrong. Every time Daddy took me out on the streets, they called me freak, demon, and things like that. Don't you see? Everybody hated me. They all did. And it was all just because I had those bumps on my face, and my left leg was like a big clump. Only Daddy loved me, and he took care of me.
But I don't get it. You were cured.
No, I never was. All this here, it started when the old woman died.
The old woman?
Yes. One day she just fell down and died. As she walked past our house, her heart stopped beating. That's what Daddy said. But all the others said it was me. That I killed the woman with wild magic. Because I'm a pathless demon. A freak. But that's a lie. I never wanted to hurt anyone. Ever. They only said that because they hated me from the start.
Say nothing.
I'm sorry. I shouldn't cry so much. They came 2 days after that happened. It was already dark, and Daddy and I were asleep when all of a sudden they came into my room and tried to pull me out of my bed. I screamed and I cried, and then Daddy came and started screaming too and punched one of the men in the face. And then one of the women pulled a knife from her coat and she...
By the gods. They killed your father?
Yes. I don't think she wanted to, but she just stabbed him in his belly again and again. And suddenly, there was blood everywhere, on the floor, on my drawings, on the bedsheets, even on Thoris's basket. Then they looked at each other in a weird way and just ran. Do you understand? They just ran and left me and Daddy there. I was so afraid, brother. I was so afraid. And then the stone started speaking to me.
The stone. So you had it with you?
Yes. Do you see the necklace? The stone is in there. Daddy said I already had it when they found me. I'm sorry I didn't tell you earlier, but I was afraid that when you found out where it was, you would just take it and leave.
And what did the stone tell you?
It said that it could make everything better, that I could make it so Daddy didn't die, and that all my wishes would come true. I would finally be able to walk like the others, and everyone would love me as if I were normal.
What did you do?
What do you think? I said, yes. Then everything went black and I felt a tickle in my tummy, like when Daddy used to lift me in the air to play Myriad. When I woke up again, everything was different. It was day, and my room was so beautiful and light, and there was toys everywhere, and Daddy wasn't bleeding anymore, but was sitting on my bed. And he told me that I just had a bad dream, and that I should go look in the mirror. And when I did, I saw that I looked different. Like the other children. Just normal.
But what does all of this mean? That this world isn't, what, real?
Yes, and no. It's the normal world, but different. It is as I want it to be.
As you wish it were.
Yes. I think that the stone can make every person here in Silvergrove see the world that I want, and do what I want them to, even before I know it myself. At first, I was so happy, you know? Everything was so beautiful, there were date pies every night, and everyone loved me. Even the other children played with me because I didn't have the bumps anymore. I was so happy.
But now you aren't anymore? Why?
Because I found out that they were only nice to me because I want them to be. And they all just do what I want them to do. All the time. When I play tag with Xces, for example, it's not really him that I'm running from. It's me. He's just like a doll. A puppet. And everyone who comes into Silvergrove becomes like that. Even if I don't want them to. But you are different. I felt it the moment Gummack let you through the gate. You see my Silvergrove? But you do what you want, not what I want.
So the stone doesn't have full power over me? How can that be?
I don't know, but whenever I look at you, it's like a part of you isn't really there. I know it sounds weird, but that's how it is.
But if you're so unhappy in this place, can't you just make the world go normal again?
No, I can't. The stone, they told me once what would happen if I did. Everyone would die, because they haven't eaten anything real for years. It's only me, only my wishes that make them healthy, you see? And even if that didn't happen, I never want to go back out there. Daddy would die, and I would have the bumps again, and everyone would hate me. That is why you have to stay. Don't you see? Together, we can be happy here, and I wouldn't be alone anymore. Please, I beg you. This is my third wish, and you promised me that you'd fulfill all of them. You promised me.
I don't care what you want. Break this illusion right now or I'll force you to.
What? No! You'd never do that! You wouldn't! The stone said you're a good person, and I know you are!
Attack Rhino, sorry, lad, I've got no time for this.
But you can't. Wait, what is this? I feel so weird. Oh no, the stone, it's in my head. Help me, brother, help me, it hurts so much.
Take the black stone from Rhino's neck.